It is being stated that the Federal Reserve Act, which privatized America's currency, was not actually formulated in Congress, but was formulated by a group of bankers who met in one of the bankers' mansions, with only one government official being present. The secrecy appears to have been required as the objective was to steal the currency of the American nation into private hands, which could not be openly announced. The objective was completed on December 23, 1913, on the day before Christmas. That's the day when the Federal Reserve Act was rammed through Congress on the last day before Christmas and was signed into law by President Woodrow Wilson on the very day. It is unlikely, looking back to this day, that anyone who had voted for the Federal Reserve Act had the faintest idea of the magnitude of the trap they were voting for. On the day that the Federal Reserve Act was signed into law, the nation began to sink. It had stepped into a monster trap that it could no longer escape. It had committed itself by its own volition, probably without being aware of it, to borrow from private sources whatever finances it needed outside of its revenue stream to defend itself and develop its economy. By America having stepped into this trap, the great national debt building began, that is still sinking the nation and the world economically. 2 months after the Federal Reserve Act was voted up, as if on cue, Europe became trapped into World War I, which America soon became trapped into as well by President Woodrow Wilson, who was threatened with a sex scandal. With this, the biggest debt building in history was underway, and so was the flow of profits into the private oligarchic system that owned the Federal Reserve. This time, however, the number of victims who had perished in the trap far exceeded the 1,500 trapped on the sinking steamship. In the now unfolding monster trap called World War I, the victims tallied upwards to 50 million. War is always arranged as a trap. It is organized behind the scene by special operatives for highly devastating objectives. Later, the nations of Europe became trapped once more into a big war, World War II, with the USA participating again in this financial waste extravaganza. The profits flowed even more richly now into the coffers of the oligarchy, while the victims, this time, tallied up to 100 million people dead. The Cold War that followed, which was already set up with the bombing of Hiroshima, the uninterrupted financial waste, this time supported the biggest military-industrial complex of all times. Humanity still remains trapped by the products that came out of the military-industrial complex. However, when the prepared for nuclear war is unleashed, humanity as a whole will be its victims. We presently live in this type of trap. As one might expect, the nuclear war game became the biggest debt-building engine of them all, and the biggest profit engine for the oligarchy, second only to currency speculation. Today, 99% of all foreign currency exchange transactions are carried out for financial speculation, and only 1% to cover trade payments. The speculative profits, of course, become losses for the nations. In this unfolding trap that much of the world is now trapped into, society is paying dearly, both in lost lives and in paying rent for the money in the trap. As you may have noted, the Federal Reserve money is not your money, but you may rent it for a fee. When the Federal Reserve Act became established in law, the oligarchy had won at the expense of civilization. For the oligarchy, the long pause leading up to it had paid off. The oligarchy now literally owns America by owning its currency, and with it, it owns much of the Western world, as its private currency has been set up evermore to function as a world currency. America itself now owns only debt, a debt that has grown so large that it will likely never be repaid, of which the interest payments presently consume 10% and upwards to 15% of the national income, while the economy keeps on diminishing. The interest payments that are received by the oligarchy as its profit do not go into physical economic development of any kind. The oligarchy has no interest in that. It finances terrorism, regime change violence, murderous revolutions, economic destruction, and whatever forces society down, especially now that financial derivatives speculation has been added. Ultimately, the profits that flow into the hands of the oligarchy finance the setting up of ever bigger monster traps. The biggest of these became the super monster trap that is presently choking the world. Its code name is Manmade Global Warming, renamed to Manmade Climate Change. It appears to have been set up to counter and squelch the cultural optimism of the Kennedy era. In only one case, after America began to die, did an American president, President Kennedy in this case, stand up for the principles of the Republic and reverse its dying by giving wings to cultural optimism. He did this with the Apollo moon landing project and with his policy of no more war. He had even ordered the withdrawal of the American forces from Vietnam. The Aristotelians acted fast to counter the president on both fronts, almost on the same day. They assassinated the president and countermanded his order for military withdrawal. The Vietnam War was escalated instead. It was demanded during the war that the Apollo moon project be cancelled before its completion, which it was. Shortly thereafter, as if it was to counteract the cultural optimism still further that the Apollo project had developed, which had lingered on, A super monster trap was set up for the whole of humanity to fall into and perish in it. As I said, this super monster trap is the trap of the man-made global warming doctrine. The trap is built on scientific fraud that actively prevents humanity from recognizing the near ice age on the horizon, which thereby blocks humanity from building itself the necessary technological infrastructures for living on the coming much colder ice age planet. It is plainly evident in plasma astrophysics that solar activity is rapidly diminishing at a whopping rate of 30% per decade, and that we are already in the boundary time zone towards a phase shift, potentially in the 2050s, that will cause the Sun to revert from its interglacial high-powered mode to its low-powered hibernation mode, where the Sun's radiated energy is reduced by 70%, with which the glacial period begins. The projection is founded on numerous forms of measured physical evidence. The evidence also makes it rather plain that a vast new world of technological infrastructures, primarily for agriculture, needs to be created that enables the present 7 billion of humanity to live on a much colder planet under a 70% weaker sun. However, all this well-established reality is hidden from society under the mantle of an engineered barrage of opinions and lies that are carefully crafted to turn truth upside down and thereby prevent the recognition of the Ice Age phase shift and society building itself a new world in the tropics for its continued living. This means that if the trap succeeds, so that the needed infrastructures are not being built before the Ice Age phase shift happens, the number of victims in the trap may be as high as 7 billion people. This is what makes the man-made global warming doctrine a super monster trap. It blocks humanity from having a future existence. It assures its near extinction. In order for the trap to succeed, the man-made global warming doctrine has transformed the whole of humanity into a self-condemning villain, whose very living on Earth, so it is said, will cause the Earth to overheat, which of course is a lie. The doctrine is designed to also function as a subliminal trap as it conjures up a problem in the mind for which no real solution is deemed possible, except for humanity to cease its living, which is not acceptable. The resulting burden of this type of trap, for which no real solutions are deemed possible, creates a regression in the mind towards ever more infantile states of thinking. With numerous Aristotelians now working for the trap, the Republican principle of the general welfare are put on the fast track of dying.